Dashboards 2.0 lets you create streamlined, modern, highly interactive charts while maintaining consistency in your design. It supports new chart types like waterfall, pyramid, and geomap, and new subchart types for radar, combination, and gauge charts. It also supports creating tabular views of data. Let's look at some samples and see how planners interact with Dashboards 2.0. This dashboard includes a tile widget with multiple values at the top. Notice the hierarchical labels in the horizontal column chart where the quarters are grouped by year. There's also a waterfall chart for P&L data. We'll investigate waterfall charts in more detail later. Finally, there's a table with plain data and a geomap in the bottom row that displays values as sized bubbles on a map layer. You can maximize any dashboard component to make it bigger. Hovering over the bubbles in the geomap displays a data label. Restore components to view the entire dashboard again. In this dashboard, notice the ring gauges with traffic lighting and the pyramid chart. Hovering your mouse over chart elements highlights the element and displays a data label. This dashboard contains a color highlight geomap that compares values and shows increases or decreases in green and red. The data label shows the comparison, in this case, plan versus actual. The table contains a spark chart, which plots column data in a mini chart on each row of the table. Tables are also searchable. The search function searches the entire table, so you can search on text or values. The revenue by category component is a combination bar line area chart, one of the many ways to visualize data as some combination of bars, lines, and areas. And the balance sheet plan component visualizes balance sheet data as a radar chart with bars. You can change the visualization for any dashboard component by clicking the chart type icon and selecting a new visualization. These user changes aren't saved with the dashboard. Notice that all of the components in this dashboard also have a custom background color. You can drill down on elements in a chart when the underlying form supports it. This is the underlying form for the bar chart. Notice that the quarters in the columns and some of the accounts in the rows are set up to drill down to more detail. The way the form is set up means that you can drill down on the account bars and the quarter label in the chart. Unlike in the form, drilling here focuses the chart only on the current level to keep the data relevant. After you drill, the chart displays links for you to drill back up. When your dashboard contains a global or local POV, changes to the POV are automatically applied. If you don't want to auto-apply changes, you can deselect Auto-Apply for the POV bar in the Dashboard Actions menu. Now when you change the POV, Apply and Reset buttons are displayed to manually apply or clear your change. Let's look at some variations of waterfall charts. You can use waterfall charts to visualize the changes in a single account over time, in this case, laptop inventory over the months of the year. Another example is this P&L statement, where expenses are shown as a negative change to total revenue, and income accounts are shown as a positive change. You can include dashboards in a custom navigation flow, as these samples were. You can also access dashboards from the Dashboards page. Dashboards 2.0 can be used alongside existing dashboards. The icon indicates which type it is. You can open dashboards from this page. By opening it here, you can edit the dashboard and its components if you have the correct permissions. The Dashboard Designer has a library panel on the left to select content, a workspace, and a properties panel on the right to set dashboard and component properties. Set the focus of the properties panel by selecting a component. You can collapse both the library panel and the properties panel to enlarge the workspace. You can exit edit mode and view the live dashboard by selecting Run Dashboard from the Actions menu. To create a new dashboard, click Create, then select Dashboard 2.0. Now you can build your dashboard. Add dashboard components by dragging a cube from the library for an ad hoc quick analysis, or by dragging a pre-built form onto the workspace. You can drag and position multiple components in the workspace. By default, a form or quick analysis from a cube displays in a table, but you can select the visualization you want. Then you adjust the chart and chart type properties until the data is visualized the way you want it. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.